problem is all inside your head, she said to me. The answer is easy if you take it logically.
Hey guys, I'm Mike Heller. So in black and white photography, if there was a mantra, it would be expose for the shadows and develop for the highlights. When you're working with a print, you're making your exposure under the enlarger to get the blacks to come up, and then you're putting it in the developing tray, and you're leaving it in there long enough for the developer to act with what little silver there is in the highlights of the print, so that you have some detail in the highlights. That's why you don't want to take your print out of the developer too soon when you're in the tray making a print. But with a negative, expose for the shadows, develop for the highlights, you have to look at it in a little bit different perspective. You're making your exposure based on the reflected value of light coming from the shadow area of your scene. And then you're going to figure out what the reflective area is from the highlight area of your scene. And you're going to adjust your development so that the highlights are rendered where you want them to be. Now, this whole thing goes back to what Ansel Adams talked about as pre-visualization. You need to be able to look at your scene, and before you set the camera, push the shutter button, before you do anything, you have to figure out what you're trying to accomplish here, what you want this picture to look like. If it's an interior photo, an exterior photo, whatever it is, you need to have an idea before you set up your camera what you're trying to accomplish. So you're looking at the dark area of the scene, and are you seeing this, whatever the dark part is, maybe it's a trash dumpster in the shadows. Are you visualizing this trash dumpster in the finished picture being a dark black, or are you visualizing it being kind of a lighter gray color, or someplace in between? Ansel Adams came up with the zone system of photography to make that visualization a little bit easier, because it divides the brightness areas in the scene into 10 different zones or steps. And each step is one stop apart from the step above and the step below it. So that the darkest zone is zone 1 and the brightest zone is zone 10. Some people make the darkest one 0, the brightest one 9. It's just the idea of having shadows and highlights and figuring out how those zones of gray relate to the print that you're trying to make. So you've got your dark area, you've got this dumpster in the shade, and you take your light meter and you measure how much light is being reflected off of that dumpster, and you use that light value to establish your exposure. If you've got a spot meter, you can just point it at the shadow area of the scene and get your reading and calculate your exposure for the shadows. If you've got an averaging meter, if you've got a roll film camera like a 120 camera or a 35 millimeter camera, you can't measure as accurately the area of the shadows from the distance that you're at. So you might have to walk up actually to the shadow area. You might have to walk up to that dumpster and get like a foot away from it. You don't have to be in focus, but you want to get close enough to it so you get your light reading reflected just off of the dumpster. If you're using a 35 millimeter camera, your camera is going to give you a reading that if you just use that, the dumpster's going to come out to an average light meter reading, and it's going to be real close to that middle gray color. It's not going to be a dark color, because your camera wants to average every scene, whether you're standing back 50 feet or you're right a foot away from it, your camera wants to give you an average light reading. So you'll have to underexpose from what the camera says, depending on how you want your picture to be. You'll have to underexpose it two stops. That's the difference from zone 5, the middle, where your camera wants to set your exposure, down to zone 3, or even down to zone 2, that would be underexposing it three stops, going from zone 5, 4, 3, 2. So you underexpose your film to get your shadow values. You make your exposure based on your shadows. Now, what does that do to your highlights? Well, if you don't do anything, it's going to underexpose your highlights as well. It's going to bring all of your values down two stops or three stops, depending on how much you underexposed it. So you need to change your development to make your highlights back where they should be. So expose for the shadows, develop for the highlights. And what that means is you have your normal development time and you have to figure out what one more stop of development is, or two more stops of development is, plus one development, plus two development. Or maybe if your scene is already very bright, maybe you need to figure out what one less stop of development is, or two less stops of development are, or maybe even three less stops of development are. So here's a scene with a dark black doorknob, gray wall, and a white door. And if you look carefully, the door up towards the top, the light is a little brighter on the top of the door than the bottom of the door. So we want to render this scene as you see it here, with a black doorknob, a white door, and the gray wall. So I'm going to measure with my spot meter. I'll take my handy dandy Pentax spot meter and I'm going to measure the brightness. I'm going to get all this lined up with the camera here. I'm going to measure the brightness of the doorknob, 2 2/3 on the doorknob, and then the brightest spot on the top of the door is 6 2/3. So here's my Pentax spot meter, and I've got the ASA in green on the top there set to 400, and I'm going to take that 2 2/3 that we measured on the black doorknob in the orange. You can see number 2, and then the second dot is 2/3, and I'm going to try and move that with one hand down there, so 2 2/3 is next to that double scratch. Now that double scratch is a Roman numeral 2 because I've scratched Roman numerals onto the barrel of my spot meter. You can see 2 3 4, the orange triangle is 5, and then there's 6 7 and 8 at the very end. So I've got my 2 2/3 that I measured on the doorknob at zone 2 about there. The exposure in the middle two rings here would be any of those combinations.
A 30th between 2 2/8, a 15th between 2 8 and 4, or an 1/8 of a second between 4 5/6.
That's your exposure, and that exposure comes when you put that 2 2/3 in zone 2. You expose for the shadows. You place your shadow values, and that determines your exposure. And then you see where your highlight values fall, and you may have to shorten or develop or lengthen your development time. Expose for the shadows, develop for the highlights. That's what it's all about. I could probably get up and do a better video outside with a real scene, but you actually get the idea here pretty clearly. The dark part we want is the doorknob. The bright part is the top of the door.
And I would imagine with all of this that that gray of the wall would fall at about zone 4 someplace. There you go. Message me if you got questions. Here's a different way of looking at it. Here's zone 5, zone 6, zone 7, zone 8, zone 9, and zone 4, 3, and zone 2.
So we measured the shadow area, and we based our exposure off of the reflected light from the shadow area. Now, the meter readings, this 2 2/3 dots and 6 2/3 dots, those are all relevant to candles per square foot, the exact amount of light being reflected. But the important thing to remember is that each number in the meter, 2, 3, 4, they're all one stop apart.
And then we measured our highlights, and our highlights measured 6 2/3 dots. We have 2 2/3, 3 2/3, 4 2/3, 5 2/3, 6 2/3. 6 2/3 should be here. In the normal progression, if 2 2/3 is here in your shadow area, then everything goes up in one-stop increments. 3 2/3, 4 2/3, 5 2/3, 6 2/3 winds up here. But we want 6 2/3 to be here in zone 7. To move this from here to here is one stop. That's plus one development. You expand the value by increasing the development. You move the highlights up higher. If I wanted the highlights in zone 8, then I would move them two stops higher, plus two development. Or if when we measured it, the highlights came out over here, we'd need to go one stop less development to get to zone 8. You with me? Message me if you're not.
Problem is all inside your head, she said to me. The answer is easy if you take it logically. I'd like to help you.